Hello everyone, so it's been a while since I last produced a video, right? Because I am quite busy in developing a new application that I'm going to release soon, and it is all about chatting anonymously, just like PolitChat, but it is kind of very anonymous and you don't even have to sign up for that. So in this video, we are going to learn about some useful tips which you can employ to create a CV which can actually help you in landing some interviews. Right now, in my previous video, I have talked about how to get that software development job, and this video can be treated as the continuation of that same series. And if you haven't checked that video out, maybe you should go and check that video out before watching this video. So let's get started. So my first tip would be include the link to your GitHub profile right at the start of your CV or maybe below your name, right? So it is easier for the employer to see your code and what kind of coding practices you follow, because I have already talked about creating a GitHub profile and releasing some of your code in public domain so that the person who are interested in hiring you can actually go through your GitHub repository and get the idea of how you actually code in real life. So including a GitHub profile link right at the top of your CV will make sure that most of the people who are going through your CV will have a look at your GitHub profile, and they will get the opportunity to see what kind of code you actually write. And if you write a good quality code and a refactored code and the code that is optimized, your chances of getting an interview will kind of increase as compared to other guys whose code those potential clients cannot see, right? So always include a GitHub profile link in your CV. And it is not even necessary to use GitHub for storing or hosting your source code. You can use Bitbucket, or you can use some other version control system that is publicly hosted to store your code. So that was my tip number one. So my tip number two would be make your CV short and simple, right? So you have to make sure that your CV is at most one page long, because seriously, you can have knowledge about so many things, but not all of the things are actually required to be put into the CV. And most of the recruiters are getting too many CVs on a day-to-day basis. So if they are going to get a 10 page CV, obviously the chances of getting that CV selected is kind of slim, because nobody has the time to read that long CV, right? So you have to make sure that your CV is quite simple and it is at most one page, okay? So don't make or don't write essays in your CV. Just write one liners or two liners in your CVs so as to convey the idea that you know the stuff, and that is it. The third tip would be don't include irrelevant experiences in your CV. See, if you have a skill of fixing bikes, but you are applying for a JavaScript job, seriously, the potential client or the recruiter is not looking for a person who knows JavaScript and who can fix bikes, right? So you can clearly leave out your experience of fixing bikes out of your CV. You don't have to mention that skill in your CV, because that kind of a skill is kind of unnecessary and not required and not have been asked for, right? So you can easily and safely leave that skill out, and there is nothing you are going to lose if you are going to leave that thing out of your CV. Just include your relevant experience in JavaScript and what you can do using JavaScript. So that was the tip number three. My last tip would be include the information about your side project, but you have to make sure that the side projects you are including in your CV are relevant to the job you are applying for. So if you are applying for a Python job, you can list down your side projects or other volunteering work you have done in Python field, or you have written some kind of automation scripts for non-profits or for hackathons, and you have participated in competitive programming and hackathons and things like that. So you can include that experience in your CV as well. That will give you some kind of edge over other participants who are not doing similar stuff and who are not taking chances to improve upon their knowledge, right? So that will also give you an upper edge. And if you have some kind of significant experience or accolades or achievements in those kind of side projects, for example, if you have created an app in Python and that app is having 20k download right? So that is kind of an achievement for you, and you can very well include that thing in your CV, and that will also make your CV stand apart from other similar CVs, right, which are not having such kind of accomplishments written over them, right? So you can do things like that. So those are some things I wanted to tell you guys, so that you can improve your CV and your CV can actually work for you, so that it can actually land you some interview calls, right? So that was my only intent in creating this video. And also make sure you subscribe to this channel, because I produce videos and because I produce career advices, computer tutorials and development videos regarding software development and software development industry. And with that, this is your guy Rajat Saxena signing off. Take care. Bye-bye.